Mr. Excel podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel podcast, episode 1874, Mr. Excel review of Excel for the iPad. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel netcast. I'm Bill Jelen from MrExcel.com. It was 4 years ago in 2010 that the first iPad debuted. My friend Jerry handed me one in the summer of 2010. I said, oh, wouldn't it be amazing to have Excel on this? Well, yesterday, March 27, 2014, Microsoft released Excel, PowerPoint, and Word for the iPad. I have to tell you, I love it. I've been using it for the better part of a day. It has amazing features. They did a beautiful job on this. But hey, it turns out this is a really long video, so let's cut to the chase right up front here. Not supported at all. Didn't ever expect this to happen. VBA macros. But no external data connections, which means no power pivot. To my surprise, hyperlinks is not working. Table slicers and timeline slicers aren't working. In fact, I can't seem to get pivot table slicers to work, but I think that's a bug with me, not with the app. All of this here in the center column, all of these you can do right on the iPad. I'm going to show you that in the video, an impressive set of editing tools on the iPad. Now, that assumes that you have Office 365. If you don't have Office 365, you can just view. And then these are things that you can create on the PC that you will then render correctly on the iPad. And we're going to take a look at all of that in the video. My advice to you is down in the description, there'll be a table of contents. If there's one particular thing you want to jump to, feel free to jump right to that. Let's get started. Now, primarily, you are going to be using Excel to consume reports that you created on the PC, but it is still very possible to create your own reports right here. And I'm just going to show you that we can do that. They've added enough features. Report sample. I'll press return. I'll go back and select that cell. And you'll see that I can change that to bold if I want, italics, underline, all the usual stuff. I can change the font size. Oh, but even better than that, the Excel 2010 cell styles are there, so I can just choose a title style and very quickly fill that data in. Here we'll type JAN for January, select the data, and then single tap and say that I want to fill, and they let me fill either down or across, so the fill handle works. All right, and then we need to, what do we need to do? We need to align that right, and that works just fine. Let's type some numbers here, so we'll put in 1,000. Of course, Excel is all about formulas, right? So we're going to start a formula here. So type the equal sign. The recently used function shows up here. So I want the round of, let's say, 1.1 times that previous number. I can just click on it like it was a mouse, and then click on number of digits, and we'll round it to 0 digits. Accept that formula. Now, when I go back, it puts it in edit mode, so I have to hit the green check mark to the right. Actually, let's do it this way. So I'll single tap, copy, and then paste, and it copies those formulas across. In fact, we can select the whole range, copy that, and paste. And then here we would want to fill going down, so let's type in 2,000 there. Select those two cells, and then say fill. It's very easy to go through and create a report from scratch. They've added enough features in here that you can make something that looks good. In fact, on the Insert tab, we can even say Insert Table, and they quickly apply the formatting. I have a new contextual ribbon tab there called Table, where I can turn on and off the banded rows if I want. Choose a different table style. All right, so you can create your own spreadsheet here with formulas, copying and pasting. It feels natural, it feels fluid. All right, let's look at some other features that they gave us. I'm going to press the new sheet icon. One of the things that I really, really hated about Excel for the iPhone was the horrible four-color palette. Right? I mean, literally, it was two-bit color. And so one of the first things I did when I opened this was, I was kind of snarky about the whole thing. I wonder, it's like, oh, but hey, look, they have all of the theme colors here. More colors, you get those colors. All right, so what, that's about 50 colors. Oh, check it out. They have every single color you want. They're all there, all 16 million colors. So kudos for that. Some other things they added that are kind of interesting. We'll get to charts later. We can insert shapes. All right, so just all the auto shape features. Choose the little cloud there. We can resize it. And now we have the shape styles, so we can choose from the various shape styles built in. Of course, those colors are based on your theme. You can choose any fill color that you want. I can rotate the shape. I can change the color of the line, and I can even click the shape and edit text and say, "This is cool." And once I have that text, I'll select all, go back to the Home tab, and choose a larger font size, change the alignment. Right? It all just works. Very, very cool. Now, are shapes the most important thing? No, they're probably not. But it's nice that they put that in. Pictures, it'll access pictures from your photo stream. Here is the keyboard that I went out and bought yesterday. Rotate that. Go. That was at Books a Million, $29, Bluetooth keyboard, so that way I could actually use the keyboard with Excel. Do you need to use the keyboard? No, not unless you have a really, really large spreadsheet. Oh, and hey, look, all the picture styles that they added in Excel 2010 are there. So we can add a little, a little oval there. I can add a reflection. Is this stuff important? No, it's not. But is it cool? Yeah, it's nice. They really went beyond. You know, just the basics, and there is a lot in there. Now, on the View tab, they have these great little toggle bars here to turn off the formula bar, turn off the sheet tabs if you want, turn off the headings, and turn off the grid lines, even freeze panes, so you can have something that doesn't necessarily look like a spreadsheet. Hey, this next one, I'm not going to call this a feature. One of the things they added was merge cells. Now, since I think that merge cells are the worst thing in the world, I never would have put that one in, but okay, just put a little tape over that part of the screen and you'll never be tempted to use that. Alright, selecting. When you first select a cell, you get that outline around it, but then to select more cells, you use one of the green dots. Very easy to do, very fluid. Let's take a look at their chart. So, insert, I'm going to use a recommended chart. They recommend a column chart for that. And then what can we edit? So we have this chart context menu up here, and we can change the chart styles. These were the Excel 2013 chart styles. Very nice. This is a quick way to apply a lot of formatting to the chart very quickly. I like these in the Excel client in Excel 2013, and they're very nice here in Excel 2010. We can choose different colors and even various layouts. Can we go micromanage the chart? No, we cannot do that. There aren't tools here to do that, but you can do that back on the PC and create a perfect chart on the PC, and then come down here and view it on the iPad. They will let us switch the axis, you know, rows and columns versus columns and rows. So enough tools to get you some really nice charts. If you're going to need to fine-tune those, you're going to have to go back to the PC to do that. All right, just finishing up on the Home tab, what else do they have there? They have number formats with a lot of different choices, but no custom. You can't create a custom number format here, but still you can go through and, you know, a lot of the different choices are there, so you can do your number formatting. All right, so you know, that's nice. Insert rows and delete rows. So this icon here will insert a sheet row or delete sheet row or column. So they give you those. Also, sort and filter. Let's see, let's sort this data descending and or ascending. All right, nice and easy. The filter dropdowns, we will take a look at those a little bit later. Okay, so hey, it's time to save this thing. And we can choose to save to either your OneDrive account or right here to the iPad, right? Isn't that cool? We can finally have like a file save as, a little file system on the iPad, which is the one thing 2010 I was really looking for. So this is just test 2. Click return, and there it's saved on the iPad. If we choose new here, they give us all sorts of templates. These are the Zach Barisi templates, very quick way to quickly create a brand new spreadsheet from scratch that you can just fill in. Now, these were created on the PC, so they have some features on the that were available on the PC that will just render here on the iPad, but still quick way to get your spreadsheets. Well, you know, of course, as you would expect, I'm going to test the limits on this thing. So here is an obnoxious file with 600,000 cells. I wanted to see how that would react on the iPad. All right, so here it is. I'm just going to start swiping. Check this out. It swipes very, very fast. Left, right, up, down. My only complaint here is I don't have control down arrow. There's no way natively on the iPad to press control down arrow, which is what I need to do to get to the very last cell. Now, if I'm lucky and I know something in the last cell, I can search for, like for example, total. You'll notice the search takes a little bit just after I start to type. It's like they're searching as I'm typing. And in this case, with 600,000 cells, it has a long way to go. Oh, there we go. We found it. All right, now let's see how it works doing an AutoSum. So we'll go to the Formulas tab, click AutoSum. I want to use the sum function and press return. And just that quick. All right, so it's very speedy. Now, this is the new iPad Air. So the fastest processor that we have today on an iPad, but it is very, very responsive. You know, and hey, by the way, the other way that you can navigate here is if you have a Bluetooth keyboard for your iPad. Now, I don't have a Bluetooth keyboard, but I went out and bought one last night. It was $29, so I just turned on the Bluetooth keyboard, and I'm pressing not Control, but Command down arrow. And I can quickly navigate down to the last cell, Control, or Command right arrow, Command up arrow. All right, but let's face it, you're not really going to be creating spreadsheets on the iPad. You're going to be creating them on the PC, sending them out to the OneDrive so others can consume them on the iPad. So let's see what the iPad can actually render. All right, so I'm throwing a lot at it here. Here's just a small data set with a chart, and I've done formatting in the chart. I also, by the way, went to page layout and changed to a different theme. Let's see if they can render the colors in that theme. Here's some slicers and a chart. Here's a pivot table with a timeline slicer, and then just a whole bunch of things I wanted to see if it would render. Will it render the new data visualizations, the data bars, the color scales, the icon sets? Will it do sparklines, spark bars, strikethrough? Will it let us do data validation, custom number formatting, hyperlinks back to menus? You know, let's see what this will do. So this is saved out on the SkyDrive. I'll save it here. I have to close it on the PC, so that way we don't have a sharing issue. And then on the iPad now, we'll open that, downloads it from the OneDrive. All right, so let's come back here to our data tab. All right, there we go. It rendered the chart even with my title, the headings. I had made the width of each, the height of each bar taller, and all of that worked fine. All right, let's do a little formula out here. So we're going to create, figure out the sales tax, and here we're going to put a tax rate. I'm currently in Florida today, so let's go with our 6% Brevard County tax rate. All right, so think about this formula. We start with an equal sign. We type the tax rate. I'm going to switch over to the formula keypad here to get my time sign, and then click on revenue. But think about this. This formula has to use the F4 key to lock that L1 down, right? Well, right here in the formula bar, I'm going to click on L1, and the context menu offers reference types, and I can say this is absolute row, absolute column. So one of the very important things that you have to be able to do in Excel is use the absolute references, and that certainly works. All right, so we will copy that cell, choose the whole range, and then paste, and our formulas now always accurately refer back to L1. Nice feature. Slicers, let's see how those look. Well, fail there. This shape represents a table slicer. That does not work. Pivot tables. Timeline slicer does not work. Will it render? All right, so all of our conditional formatting does appear. The spark line appears, the spark bar appears, Strikethrough appears. Let's see how the data validation looks. So we select that cell, we get a little drop down, and we can choose from the drop down a custom number format. So let me change that to number 1. I have a program that 1 will put a checkbox in. Not program, but just using a custom number format. And hyperlinks. Can we hyperlink back to a different sheet? Oh, that's really disappointing. We needed hyperlinks, and it doesn't look like that's working. Hey, for a test, I just went back to the PC and changed this pivot table and added a region slicer, and it is not rendering at all. So a little disappointing that the table slicers and the timeline slicers and the pivot table slicers are not rendering here. I mean, they, after all, they do it in the Office web app. I thought that would have been one that we had. All right, let's take a look at the filter feature. I promised I'd do that. So here we have our data set. We turn on the filter, and then here in the drop downs, we can unselect all and just choose product ABC. Of course, the chart automatically updates just like in regular Excel. So the filters work. There is no search that they added in Excel 2010 to the filters, but you know, that's generally okay. All right, an interesting, do they have the format painter? Let's try the format painter. So we choose some sort of a color here, and then I will copy that cell and then select a range of cells and paste formats. That's essentially the format painter, so that works. Here's one that's not going to be surprising to Office pros, but might be surprising to people who just generally use the iPad. So we're here in an application called Excel for the iPad, and I copy this chart, and then let's go back to the main menu, and I'll open PowerPoint. I'll create a new presentation, and then paste, and remarkably, the chart from Excel gets pasted right here into PowerPoint. So we actually have copy and paste between two different apps, which is very, very rare on the iPad. You know, one of the beautiful things is you're working on your PC and the iPad, everything stays in sync with the OneDrive. So I just created a brand new file on the PC called Array Formula, and see it just pops right in my recent items there. Okay, so here is a fairly ugly array formula that I created on the PC that is analyzing 49 years of dates. Let's see if we can change the formula. Let's see if we can change the input cells and have that array formula recalculate. Yes, that works. I wonder if we can edit the formula here. So testing for, instead of Friday the 13th, testing for Friday the 23rd. Press enter, and wow, that actually works. That allows us to edit the array formula. Hey, back on the PC. Okay, now I don't expect any of these to render on the iPad. If any of them do, I'll be amazed. WordArt, SmartArt, a object with 3D insert screen clipping, and then the camera tool. So I'm really honestly just don't expect any of this to work. But we'll save it. We'll close it. Wow, that's pretty crazy. Every single one of those is working, including the camera tool. That can't possibly be working. Hang on. Let's change that number to something else. And scroll down. No. Okay. Yeah. So the camera tool is static. That would have been way cool. But WordArt, SmartArt, and our 3D bevel is working very nice. All right. So there you have it. Overall, I'm really impressed. I never expected macros to work. I don't think they'll ever work. But the things here that you're able to create on the iPad are great. The things that render on the PC are great. These two I'm still not sure on. Hyperlinks, it seems buggy to me. I can't get it to link to another spot in the worksheet, but they have UI for hyperlinks, so I'm just not doing it right. Pivot table slicers, they're not rendering. I'm not sure if that's a bug. We'll figure that one out. Overall, very, very impressive. Great job. Kudos to the team at Microsoft that designed Excel for the iPad. It came out great. But hey, there you have it. Thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast, Mr. Excel.